But first, two family homes in Sydney's west have been sprayed with more than 35 bullets in what police suspect were drug-related warnings.
In one of the attacks, a woman's foot was slashed with glass during a hail of gunfire that narrowly missed children.
Gunmen in Sydney's west have notched up more than 30 drive-by attacks in just 5 months, but few as disturbing as this. At least 26 shots were fired outside this family home, narrowly missing children. Minutes earlier, another 15 bullets were pumped into this house at Auburn. The gunmen are believed to have torched their getaway car in this suburban street.
And all of a sudden I could hear these bangs one after the other, probably about 8 or 10. But I'm seriously thinking it's time to move out.
All up, 25 people were inside the two houses at the time, the youngest just 10 months old. Incredibly, the only injury was to a woman in her 20s, her foot slashed as windows exploded around her.
Basically, there's just a bit of shrapnel that's come off and hit her in the foot. She's all right, it's just a small graze, that's all.
Police are investigating whether the shootings are linked to a drug feud between Middle Eastern crime gangs.
Certainly a message was being sent. It was deliberate, it was targeted, and it was reckless.
The innocent victims of the Auburn attack are baffled as to the motive.
Basically, a car just pulled up, started shooting and just left. Oh, we don't know, okay, mistaken identity, I guess.
Witnesses have told police they saw two men run from the scene after setting this car alight just before 11 p.m.
Both shootings are being investigated by a recently formed task force assembled to investigate a spike in the supply of drugs by organised crime gangs. Detectives fear more attacks could follow, saying there is a strong likelihood of retaliation.
Matt Doran, 10 News.